ba, kababayan? Turn it up! Kababayan, andito po ako ulit ngayon upang ipakita sa inyo hindi lang isa, dalawa, kundi tatlong pinaka-ingrandeng festival sa Pilipinas. Gusto mo yun? Gusto ko yun! Tara na! At ang pinakauna sa lahat ay ang ati-atihan ng Kalibo, dubbed as the mother of all festival in the Philippines. Kalibo's ati-atihan. Ito ay ang pinakamatandang pagdiriwang sa bansa. It's a two-week merriment that culminates on the third Sunday of January. Kasing aga ng Desyembre, you will hear drum beats as participants practice for the upcoming event. Sa pagdiriwang, people dressed in costumes made of indigenous materials gather in the street and dance to the beat of the drums. Yung balat nila ay binablackened to represent the early settlers known as Ati. Chants of Viva Santo Niño and Halabira Para Pasma can be heard along with the rhythmic cadence of tribal music. The first phrase is a tribute to the baby Jesus, and the second is a plea not to get sick under the sweltering heat of the sun. Sa huling mga dekada, different cities have come up with their own version, but ati-atihan is unique for one major reason. It is very interactive. Locals are not just mere spectators, they paint their skin black with soot and join the groups in street dancing. Do not be put off if you get wet with some beer spray, after all, it's the local equivalent of Mardi Gras. Ang pangalawa ay ang Mascara ng Bacolod. The Mascara Festival of Bacolod City ay usa ka sikat nga kapistahan dinhi sa Visayas. Believe it or not, the festival has been giving local and international visitors the chance to have fun, drink, and party on the streets of Bacolod for over 30 years now. Ito ay 20-day street party replete with food, drinks, dances, and a bevy of wild contests like chasing after a pig and downing coconut milk. This annual festival, which is similar to Brazil's Rio Carnival, literally translates to many faces and is celebrated every October in Bacolod. Because of the smiling faces of the mask, ginatawag ang Bacolod City ng the City of Smiles. The Mascara Festival can trace its roots back in the 1980s and was born out of a crisis. It was during the time when the province's main livelihood, sugar, was priced at an all-time low because of alternatives introduced in the market. It was also the time when a tragic ferry accident happened, which carried mostly people from the province, including those from prominent families of Bacolod. But to lift the spirits of the locals and bring back the smiles on their faces, the Mascara Festival was created. The smiling masks were a declaration of the people of Bacolod City that they will pull through and survive the challenges and tragedies that they are facing. Ang pinakaulahi na ilakining a grandest festival sa Pilipinas, ang Sinulog Festival. Sa kadugay na kung nga nagbuyo din sa Cebu, hininga kapistahan, mo'y labi kaduol sa kung kasing-kasing, dili laman sa ako, apan sa tanan kanato din hi, mga kapwa Cebuanon. Daghan kayong nagaingon nga, pariyado kong nang ni Senyor Santo Niño niya itong gamay pa ko. Agliba mo? Ug ang akong adlaw nga natawhan duol pud sa Sinulog kani atong 2004. Sa batan-on pa sila moapilo sab sila sa mga Sinulog contests ug banghalan og sayo sa atong patron nga Santos ng Cebu. Ang akong inahan usa usab ka festival queen sa lumad ba sa canons kani atong high school pa siya. Mauna na sukad sa bata pa ko, wish ko gyud nga makasayaw sa matag kalihukan sa Sinulog ug hangtod karon dili gayud ni mawala ang pagkaimportante sa Sinulog nako. Mauna sa kung unsa ako pwede mabuhat para makahalad lang kog sayaw ni Santo Niño, ako jud nang buhaton. Well, share ko lang. Enough sa ating chika minute. Bao ba ka? Now this is deemed as the biggest event in the Philippines and is considered to be first and queen of festivals in the Philippines. The Sinulog Festival attracts about 1 to 2 million people every year.
It is held on the third Sunday of January as a Thanksgiving event for the patron saint, the Santo Niño. It is so popular that many people will go out of their way to travel to Cebu to witness the event and will book hotels as early as December. Aside from the religious aspect of the festival, Sinulog is also famous for its street parties, usually happening at night before and at the night of the main festival. Sinulog is the ritual prayer dance honoring Señor Santo Niño or the Child Jesus. The image believed to be miraculous is housed at the Basilica Menorah del Santo Niño in downtown Cebu City. Today, the Sinulog commemorates the Filipino people's acceptance of Christianity and the rejection of their former animist beliefs or worship of nature. The first of these conversions happened in 1521 on the island of Cebu, when Indianized and Sanskritized ruler Raja Humabon and his queen Amihan Humamay were baptized along with their subjects, becoming Carlos and Juana of Cebu.
Kung karon ipakita ka na ko kaninyo ang usa ka video nga nagpakita o paghalad na mo kay Señor Santo Niño kauban ang akong tibuok pamilya.
Viva! 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 Vi